Good morning to all of you. My name is Monique Robo. I'm an epidemiologist working at the Erasmus University Medical Center in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. Before we can start on current and future prostate cancer screening practices, it is important to realize that the basis of all our work today comes from randomized trials initiated in 1993 in Europe and that were the Göteborg trial in Sweden and a European-wide larger ERSPC trial. The Göteborg screening trial, where 20,000 men were randomized in a control and screening arm, currently has 22 years of follow-up. The algorithm, a one-size-fits-all approach based on elevated PSA and random prostate biopsy, resulted in a PPV of 20% and 47% of all prostate cancer detected could be considered as low-risk cancers. The mortality reduction in favor of screening is currently 29%. The ERSPC trial, comprising of 8 centers in Europe, has randomized 162,000 men, currently has 16 years of follow-up. Also applying a one-size-fits-all approach, we see comparable results. A PPV of 24% and 56% of cancers detected being low risk. The relative mortality reduction in favor of screening is 20%. Overall conclusion from these trials is that screening can reduce suffering and dying from prostate cancer, but with the applied algorithm coincides with unnecessary testing and overdiagnosis, often directly related to overtreatment. Over the years, this knowledge has led to changes in clinical guidelines, pleading for a more individualized approach and shared decision-making, and the inclusion of more risk stratification steps, including MRI. These are, however, clinical guidelines, but what is currently happening in the field of population-based screening? I will shortly address contemporary screening trials and the next step, screening programs. In this slide, we see an overview of ongoing trials where within this meeting, PROBASE and Stockholm 3 will be addressed separately. I will provide a short update on ProScreen and Göteborg 2. ProScreen is a Finnish trial led by the University of Tampere and Helsinki and has in 2023 published their algorithm in the BJUR. ProScreen was initiated in 2018 and the plan is to randomize 120,000 men into a control and screening arm. Individual risk assessment is key in this trial, and for that PSA level, the 4K score and MRI are used to define rescreening intervals and the need to proceed for prostate biopsy. The anticipated flow is shown here. It is clear from this slide that the algorithm aims to avoid unnecessary MRIs and biopsies and with that to avoid overdiagnosis. In the end of 1,000 men included, 32 men will need to be biopsied. Based on historical data, it is anticipated that low-risk cancer detection rate will be below 50%. The data presented in this slide are from the beginning of this year, showing that recruitment is well on the way and compliance to the algorithm, the risk-based algorithm, is actually excellent, which is encouraging. The Göteborg 2 trial knows a rather complicated algorithm where it was the aim to randomize approximately 58,000 men in the period 2015 up to 2020. It is a three-arm trial where baseline PSA is the basis of rescreening intervals and where systematic biopsy, yes or no, is being tested, as well as a lower PSA cutoff in relation to overdiagnosis and significant prostate cancer detection. The first publication of the Göteborg 2 trial appeared this year in a New England journal, concluding that in a population-based setting, including MRI, a systematic approach could be omitted. Interesting to see is the fact that with MRI directly after a PSA of 3 or higher results in 66% of the MRI being benign, something that could need some approval. We were just discussing ongoing trials, with again a comparison between a control arm and a screening arm. However, the review from the scientific board advising the European Parliament concluded in 2022 that the evidence currently available on prostate cancer screening also is sufficient to consider starting up national pilots for population-based screening. This has resulted in an update of the EU recommendations of cancer screening, opening the way for prostate cancer screening. To support this and to give it a kickstart in Europe, a funding call was launched by the EU for lung, prostate and gastric cancer. For prostate, the EU-led PRAISE-U study is funded and started last April, just like a lung and gastric cancer initiative. PRAISE-U will focus on generating a living knowledge platform on prostate cancer screening activities in all EU member states and will run some pilot studies. The pilots will be initiated in Ireland, in Spain at two locations and in Poland. OPT Sweden, the PSA testing program in Sweden which is ongoing, and ongoing initiatives in Estonia and Lithuania will both share as implementation but mostly as knowledge sharing sites. More countries in the EU have indicated to start up pilots for prostate cancer screening and aim to share their knowledge and data with the PRAISE-U platform. We are currently in the next phase of population-based prostate cancer screening, and the updated EU recommendations have opened the way to start to look at opportunities for nationally tailored programs. It goes without saying that the long-term follow-up of the ongoing randomized trials will be closely followed and will be the basis of future decision-making. Thank you for listening.